I'm here again on the Senate floor to urge all of my colleagues to vote for an extension of the production tax credit for wind energy, otherwise known as the PTC. And today, as I've been doing, I will focus on an individual state. I'm going to look at the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania and show all of us the promise that it holds as a wind energy manufacturing hub, as well as the negative effects that will occur if we don't extend the production tax credit. Pennsylvania has a strong blue-collar background and an extraordinary number of highly skilled workers. And with those factors, those positive elements in Pennsylvania, it has seamlessly transitioned into a wind energy powerhouse. If you look at this map here of the state of Pennsylvania, from Philadelphia, you'll see this, from Philadelphia to Rockwood, from Pittsburgh to Scranton, you have wind projects all over the state, and those wind projects have created good-paying jobs and stability for Pennsylvania families. Pennsylvania, as I've alluded to, has long been a center of manufacturing in the United States, and the wind industry has taken note. You see these green circles on the map, and each one of those indicates a manufacturing facility that makes parts for wind turbines in the state of Pennsylvania, and that represents over 20 plants and hundreds of employees in the state of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. And I would suggest, Mr. President, that the state of Pennsylvania is only really beginning to realize its potential when it comes to the wind energy industry. Now, my colleagues know I've been on the floor talking about the economic benefits of wind energy, and I want to highlight what's happened in Pennsylvania. If you look at this chart, the wind energy industry, it supports 4,000 jobs. You have 180,000 homes that are powered by wind, and you have conservatively $1.4 million in property taxes from wind projects that go to local communities. So this is an important set of numbers. It's money, particularly on the tax side, that helps local communities pay for basic services, and it's just critical in this time of decreasing local and state budgets. If you think about it, all of these figures, the jobs, the revenues, the investments, they're primed for significant growth going forward. But that future, that growth, are going to be threatened unless we act, unless the Congress acts to extend the production tax credit. Mr. President, just last week, Gamesa, which is a global leader in the manufacturing of wind turbines, announced that it's ending the development of the Schaefer Mountain Wind Farm, which is in northeastern Somerset County. And this project would have ultimately ended up with 30 new wind turbines, and it was planned to come online in 2013. That's just 6 months from now. But because of the uncertainty tied to federal policies like the production tax credit, Gamesa has sidelined this project. In short, our inaction is costing this community jobs, this Commonwealth of Pennsylvania jobs. And it just doesn't make any sense in the current economic environment that we now face, and as our nation's desperately focused on becoming more energy independent. The Pittsburgh Post-Gazette made the point that this is the third wind project under development that's been stopped all in the last month just because of the uncertainty we've created here by not extending the PTC. Now, these are on-the-ground examples of how congressional inaction is costing American jobs investment. And I know the presiding officer knows this isn't a partisan or regional issue. There's strong bipartisan support for extending the production tax credit. And the wind industry has a presence in almost every single state in our country. So if you look at the overall picture, this just isn't the time for companies like Gamesa to grow reluctant to invest in the future. So we've got to expand the PTC. It will incent this industry to continue its rapid growth, and it will build a strong foundation for a 21st century clean energy economy. So I'm again on the floor urging my colleagues to work with me to extend the wind production tax credit as soon as possible. And Mr. President, as I close, I wanted to highlight an event that's here on Capitol Hill today where members, staff, and others can learn more about the potential of wind energy, as well as other types of renewable and energy efficiency technology. And that event is the 15th Annual Renewable Energy and Energy Efficiency Expo. It's underway all day in the Cannon Caucus Room on the House side. The bipartisan Senate Renewable Energy and Energy Efficiency Caucus, which I co-chair along with Senators Lieberman and Crapo, is an honorary co-host of the event as well. I want to encourage all of us to go over there, look at the technologies. They're awe-inspiring, they're awesome, they're truly the future. And when we implement policies that will help these technologies penetrate all these various markets, we're going to continue to be a leader in the clean energy economy. So I'll be back next week to talk about the wind production tax credit. I'll be here every day until we pass it and we extend it.